Hello and welcome to this short ThingLink spotlight video. We wanted to share with you some of our favourite ThingLinks. Not only are they our favourites, but educators are telling us that they are inspiring them too. One particular design style that we've seen a big increase of in the use of ThingLink is virtual tours around a school, around a college, around a university campus. This is especially important as students cannot physically visit to support their transition onto the next place of education. There's a saying that there are those that follow maps and there are those that make them. In this short video, we'll be finding out more directly from Luke at Keele University, who's created this ThingLink map to be a virtual tour to the Geography, Geology and Environment Department of Keele University to do just that, to help their students manage that transition to university. Over to you, Luke.
Cheers, Louise. Hello, everyone. My name is Luke Hobson, and I'm a technician for the School of Geography, Geology and Environment at Keele University in the sunny Midlands of England. But it's not like I'm getting to see much of that sun at the moment, because like most of you, I'm locked down and I'm working from home. But that's given me the opportunity to get really stuck in and get creative using a platform you all know as ThingLink. So just before the university closes doors to the staff and students at Keele, we were scheduled to host an offer holder day for students accepted onto one of our courses, as well as students still deciding if Keele University was for them. Obviously, that couldn't happen, so myself and a few others were asked to work on a virtual offer holder day we could host on the school website, which gives prospective students a little taste of what's been going on in the school, as well as what they can be getting involved in both on and off campus. Now, we have been collecting an archive of 360-degree footage for the past 2 years using Ricoh Theta 5s and Theta Z1 360-degree cameras. We've been doing this both on and off campus, and especially during overseas field trips, because we've wanted to create an interactive virtual field trip for the classroom so that students can visit the site virtually and better prepare themselves for work out in the field. Also, so that students who are unfortunate not to go on the field trips actually get a chance to go on them. And this year being a prime example of that, as all of us are grounded at the moment and all field trips have actually been cancelled. We discovered that ThingLink was obviously the best platform out there, which allowed us to do that quite easily. And we've been using ThingLink for about a year now. So for the virtual offer hold today, we decided to create an interactive GG campus map using ThingLink. Starting with a nice welcome page designed on Microsoft PowerPoint, we really wanted to promote the ThingLink buttons. We greeted the user with an audio file and guided them with on-screen text to advance to the selection menu. Once on the selection menu, Google Earth was used to download a picture of the campus, and I created a tiled selection screen you can see here, again using Microsoft PowerPoint. I wanted it to almost feel like a main screen of a computer game. On the map, I also included a selection of 360-degree videos at various locations around campus where some of our practical classes are actually taking place, as you can see in this video here. I also embedded 3D models, which were hosted on Sketchfab, created using the drone technologies that we have and the students get to use, and they develop these models themselves, as well as other videos and stills from a variety of places on campus, especially of interest to prospective students, with them in mind. We also got to introduce people to our new facilities, also some of the equipment that's in them facilities, and they get to take a look at some of our field trip 360-degree images and videos too. We thought this was the best way for the students to get a feel of what the department has to offer, really. It's simple and easy to use, and it's also accessible because we included audio notes that read all text for you, and also added in navigational help button to assist those that may not have had a play with anything like this before. I'd say, given the circumstances that we're currently living in, this is pretty much the next best thing to actually being there. And there's even an option to use Google goggles on some of these images and videos, which so you can do it in VR, which is also pretty cool. We're kind of lucky that we had all the footage for this ThingLink in advance, really, of a lockdown, because I couldn't get out there and record any new footage for it. But without any distractions and working from home, I managed to put this together in just a few days. ThingLink makes it really easy for anyone to do, really. I wouldn't have a clue how to put anything together like this using any other software or package. And so far, we've had a positive response to the interactive map, both from academic staff and prospective students, especially since the offer holder day page went live. And we really think that it makes the department stand out, and I highly recommend using it. But that's it for me. So now back to Louise.
Thanks, Luke. That's been a fantastic example from Keele University, and I can't thank them enough for sharing that with us. And the work of Luke and his team of technicians that are supporting Keele University. And I hope that's given you a flavour of how easy it is to use. And we've also offered a solution, particularly in the current climate. So thank you for watching. Don't forget to join us on Facebook or Twitter. ThingLink Education is our Facebook group, and we'll post a bunch of links into this spotlight thing link as well. So thank you for watching, and we'll continue sharing, and please do continue sharing with us too.